This is the third video from the percentages module, and in this video we're going to look at problem solving questions where you're required to make a percentage. And in this one we need to find what percentage 13 is out of 30. And the way we need to do this is we need to look at which one of these numbers represents our total, and that number is our total, and this is our part of the total. So that means that written as a fraction, this will be 13 out of 30, and to make it a percentage we need to times by 100. So, and that will be our percentage. So if we do that with a calculator, so on a calculator here we need to go 13 divided by 30 times by 100, or we can go 13 times by 100 divided by 30. It doesn't matter, because if you recall, in order of operations, multiplication and division have equal precedence. But getting to an answer for this, this comes out at 43.3 reoccurring percent. So we may need to use a bit of common sense here. I would write this down personally as 43.3%. The second question: at the beginning of the year, Julia's height was 150 centimetres. During the year, she grew 5 centimetres taller. What was the percentage increase in her height? Okay, the key word here is increase. So the first of the three steps, which are present in the module, suggests that you actually write down the increase. The increase is 5. So the fraction increase. Now we need to compare that back to the original. So it's 5 out of an original 150. And then to make it a percentage, this is 5 over 150 times by 100. This could be done as a fraction. We could go 50 into this, but I'm sure most people will grab a calculator and go 5 divided by 150 times by 100 is 3.3 reoccurring percent. So the answer to the question I would put as 3.3%. I've rounded to one decimal place. The third question: on a journey, on a 575 kilometre journey, 240 kilometres was travelled by lunchtime. What percentage of the journey is left to cover? So it's what percentage is left to cover. So we need to look at what's left to cover. Now, the journey was 575 and we've done 240. So the amount that's left to cover must be 575 subtract 240, which means that we must have 335 kilometers left to travel. So the fraction of the journey still to travel is 335 out of a total of 575. So if we want to make that a percentage of the journey, then that is 335 divided by 575 times by 100, which we definitely need a calculator for, and that comes out at 58.26 something percent. So I've rounded that to two decimal places at that. You might also consider going just to one decimal place, in which case it would be 58.3. And the last question in this section, last week a DVD cost $29.95. This week it's only $22. What is the percentage discount? Our key word here is discount. So let's look at discount. So the discount must have been $29.95 subtract $22, which turns out to be $7.95. So that means that the fraction discount, relative to the original price, must be $7.95 out of $29.95. So that means that our percentage discount must be $7.95 out of a total of $29.95 times by 100. And that comes out to two decimal places to be 26.54%.